Thank you, and thank you for that kind introduction. Yeah, I'm going to anchor kind of how does all this play in the marketplace, and that's kind of reflective of where many of you are headed out into the marketplace. You may be working for a small, medium-sized company. You may be working for a Fortune 50 company, but all of you eventually will find your way out into the marketplace, and I will tell you the diversity and beyond diversity and the multicultural marketplace is fundamentally reshaping the landscape of not just how products are marketed, but product design, packaging, the entire envelope for what you see in the marketplace now, including store design and display and all that kind of stuff, fundamentally being reshaped by a very fast changing multicultural diverse marketplace. And I think in considering how beyond diversity plays into the theme of, okay, how does that apply to business, clearly beyond means we're not going to be reactive, we're not going to be generic, we are going to be proactive, and we are going to be sensitive. We're going to be sensitive to our consumers, we're going to be sensitive to shoppers, we're going to be sensitive to our employees, we're going to engage them, we're going to listen, we're going to study, and we're going to involve ourselves in developing products and strategies that have real, not just appeal, but value to those shoppers and to those consumers. Now, because we have roughly 12 minutes, I'm going to key in on one as an example, one multicultural market segment that is really getting a lot of attention right now, and it is the Hispanic market. The Hispanic market is large, it's complex, and as you're going to see here in a couple of slides I put together, it is extraordinarily powerful economically. You can see here that the real growth in the marketplace is multicultural growth. You can see the market segments here from about 10 million, you know, various ethnic groups, Asian, African American, Black, Hispanic, and non-Hispanic white. But the growth is really coming in multicultural. That is where the economic action is. That is where the societal action is. And when you get out into the marketplace, and many of you, you know, have part-time exposure there, you're going to see in any of the companies you work for a real emphasis on that. And it's not just a feel-good anymore. Feel-good doesn't cut it. It has to be real and tangible. You can see here, just in terms of the growth of the population, you know, we've got Hispanic growing at 167%. The Asian population, 142%. You see down here, non-Hispanic white is pretty much flat. So if you're in business, you're certainly recognizing that there are significant changes taking place in the U.S. marketplace, and you better be on your toes. You better be highly adaptive, and I don't mean in superficial ways. It has to be real, and it has to be tangible. And frankly, many major companies you're seeing in terms of leadership, women, you're seeing ethnic minorities taking the helm in, if not CEO and president positions. You're seeing key positions in shopper marketing, in insights, in product development, in marketing, being headed up by people who reflect this change internally. So there are many, many, many opportunities. Let's drill down here very quickly and see how this plays on a little bit more sophisticated level. When you think, okay, Hispanic marketing, you're thinking Univision, you're thinking, okay, we're going to maybe create some Spanish language commercials. Well, if you just take the same old stuff and translate it into Spanish, you don't necessarily have a successful multicultural marketing campaign, because why? You're not sensitive. You haven't built the campaign from the ground up, including the product, on that shopper and their specific cultural interests, tastes, needs, preferences, priorities. So let's take a look at this Hispanic household, because this is kind of interesting. Hispanics over-index in many, many key areas of interest to business. I've selected four here. In terms of household, and I know it's hard to envision 0.4 of a person, but just in terms of averages, the U.S. average is 2.4 people per household, 3.4 for Hispanic households. Kids, number of households that have children, half of Hispanic households have children. The U.S. average is 30%. That's a huge difference. This one down here, children per household. More than one per household for Hispanic households. The U.S. average is 0.5. And then finally, where the rubber hits the road for business is, and you might not be able to see this because of the podium, but the cumulative lifetime spend per household is $2 million currently. That number's going up, as I'm going to show you here in a second, versus non-Hispanic white at 1.6 versus 2, African-American at 1.3 versus 2. So the economic power of the Hispanic market is extraordinary, and it's growing. You can see here, as you begin to drill down, there are significant differences within this demographic. There are foreign-born Hispanic, U.S.-born Hispanic. The fastest-growing segment, believe it or not, is U.S.-born. That's the segment of the Hispanic population that's growing the fastest. They also wield the most economic power. And you look at non-Hispanic, that's way down. So if I'm Coke, if I'm Pepsi, if I'm Chevrolet, if I'm Apple, any of the products and services, the clothing companies, toys, I'm interested, real interested in this market. And I better be seriously interested in this market by being sensitive to the diversity in this marketplace, in this particular market. Now, I'm not saying, you know, everything is focused on the Hispanic market at all. What I'm showing you is the methodology that's used by business to really determine how best to implement a strategy. Size of market, buying power, where they are, who they are, what their needs, interests are, and the companies that I'm going to feature as being really good or recognized at really investing in multicultural and diversity marketing are companies that aren't just looking at one, but looking at all the diverse groups within their constituency, their national market. This just reinforces the increase in consumer spending by Hispanics. It will go up 74% over the next 10 years. Here you can see, okay, all right, where do they over-index? Well, these are product categories that are essentially being driven to new heights because of the Hispanic consumer. And you can see it's pretty diverse. Baby formula, beer, deodorizer and freshener, eggs, flour and meal, isotonic beverages, Mexican food, shampoo and conditioner. This is just a sampling. But when we say over-index, what I mean by that is these product categories overall have a certain sales level that's 100%. That's the average. If you look at products sold in subgroups, if the index is 120%, that means that that particular constituency is over-indexing. As a group, they're spending more than the average national total. So these are all over-indexing heavily. Isotonic beverages, 208%. Huge, okay? The Hispanic shopper is also plugged in. 70% of non-Hispanics own a smartphone. 79%, the over-indexing number for the Hispanic consumer. So They're using technology not only to make buying decisions, they may be price comparing using the scanner and price comparison apps on their smartphone. They're going online to check on deals, specials, promotions. They're using social media to communicate and share what they find with their family, their friends. So in sum, who are these digitally engaged shoppers? They're younger. They tend to be fairly evenly split. Right now, Hispanic skew a little bit more male. Hispanic and bicultural is a key characteristic of the digitally engaged consumer. They tend to be married. They tend to have children, tend to be educated, employed, and a little bit higher income than average. And in sum, these are some of the things that marketers have to live by. And one is the fact that US-born acculturated Hispanics are really the ones driving the marketplace right now, and they are creating their own culture. There are all kinds of new trends, new tastes that are coming from the acculturation of not just Hispanics, but the descendants of second, third generation people who really are adapting to each other in a multicultural framework. They're adapting to the existing US culture and shaping and changing it across the board. In music, you hear the term fusion. There's fusion in food. There's fusion in lifestyle. There's fusion in taking different cultural characteristics and merging them together. Your generation is having a lot to do with driving that. This campus population is very reflective of that merging of cultures and that first to second to third generation transformation that's really driving things. And it's not going to stay the same. And these marketers and these companies know it. It will constantly be changing. It's changing at a higher velocity all the time. So these are just a few things. They're, you know, the differences in the acculturation between foreign-born and those that are born in the United States. Basket spend and composition just means businesses are looking at what you put in your shopping basket, and they're seeing significant differences in what you're actually spending money on. We've already covered that the key to CPG, that's consumer packaged goods companies, the key to their growth and their future is understanding this beyond diversity, multicultural thing and adapting to it. And they have to view the landscape differently for each segment. As I said before, if you look at the old black and white commercials and magazine ads for anything from television sets, radios, cars, Coca-Cola, it was pretty white bread and pretty uniform back in the 50s and 60s. One size fits all, the mass market, the Mad Men made, you know, kind of notorious and famous through the TV show that recently was on the air. I mean, that whole era was based on coming up with one concept with mass appeal to everybody. That is way gone. That doesn't work. And I'm going to show you a couple of things here that I think will reinforce that. Now, the top five, number one is McDonald's. And let me just show you a commercial here. Oh, that's the pointer. Can we play that right off the computer? Now, this commercial...
Luis! Hey! Ándale, ya llegaron tus amigos.
Okay.
Can we lower the lights? Is that possible?
Luis! Hey, what's up, guys?
Peel, play, ole, ole from McDonald's. And you could win a trip for two to the FIFA World Cup Final in Rio. There's something new to love at McDonald's.
You can see sports. You can see family. You can see first generation, second generation. That was a big game. The green, obviously, that's Mexico, and you know the younger group was U.S. You know, it's just reflective of so many of the themes we just talked about, and so that's McDonald's. I got just one more. Pepsi has been in this a long time, and they've brought back a lot of learnings from being a global company back to the U.S. Let's just play. I've got one more here. We'll play this. This is Pepsi.
Y ahora, para animar el turno de noche, Shakira.
Concert promotion, that could be a bodega or a convenience store. A lot of things embedded in back of that you know, it's fun. You know, that one actually is in Spanish. Actually, there's not a whole lot of talking going on, more dancing and music, but reflective of you know, a number of the trends. So I'm going to wrap up with the next three here. Chevrolet has made a big investment in multicultural marketing. Western Union, this is one of the primary ways that funds are sent to families outside the United States, so they've had a real resurgence. And Walmart, no matter what you think of them, they are the biggest of the retailers out there, and they have made a really strong effort to try to understand their shoppers, and frankly, they've done really well from a business standpoint. So that's it. I think I've gone soundly over my allotment, but I hope I've given you a few things, a few insights on the business side of diversity and the imperative for you, when you get into the business world, to carry on this whole idea that it must be progressive, proactive, sensitive, and real. And I think you are best positioned to do that and be that light in the marketplace. Thank you very much.